I'm sure that after 18 years as an entrepreneur, after Jesus took his business and turned it into the call of God, he knew that if you got a great idea, a great product, you got to sell it. That's right. You've got something good. Even something good has to be sold. Well, how did he do that? There's something else Jesus knew. He knew that a good question is a good idea. And you know what one of his favorite questions was? Here we go. What do you want me to do for you? That's right. What do you want? By the way, if Jesus would ask you that question, what would you answer? What do you want? What do you want me to do for you? Well, if you'll give me just 10 minutes on this Tuesday evening, I'm going to try and bring those two stories together and perhaps give you something to think about, something to consider, and maybe something that just might change your life and business as you seek to join us. The program is The Master Entrepreneur, and it begins right now. Indeed, the name of the program is The Master Entrepreneur. Hopefully, a guide to true greatness. Hopefully, a way to increase your ideas, your influence, your impact, and maybe even your income. We're here to help you do what you want to do as a Christian entrepreneur. And this program is brought to you by the Christian Entrepreneur Network at tcenglobal.org. And if you could help sponsor this program, we would be grateful. Your contribution, your support, your sponsorship would be welcome. In fact, I would love if one of you would step forward and say, Stan, you know what? My company and my business will take care of the expenses for this program. And by the way, all we will kind of expect perhaps is a bit of a mention from time to time. That's the way business works, and that's the way we will work, too. Well, here we go. Got those two stories. You know, Jesus says, I know I've got to sell this. And obviously, it's very, very true that, look it up. One of his favorite questions was, what do you want? What do you want me to do for you? Well, let me tell you about my good friend Bob, and you're going to meet him sometime. Bob was in the insurance industry for many years, the financial services industry, and we connected at a little patio party one time here in Arizona, and because I had spent many years, and still do, work within the coaching circles of the financial services, we had a lot in common. It turns out that both of us being from the Minnesota area, we not only had a lot in common in terms of calling an industry, knew a lot of the same friends, knew a lot of the same episodes in the industry. So we hit it off. Well, in his modest way, Bob really indicated that he had been very good at this. He was really good. Now, I had worked with a lot of people in the industry who were really good, and so obviously I wanted to know a little bit more about him and his success. How did he do that? Particularly, he was in one of the toughest industries around in terms of product. You know, everybody needs car insurance. If you're going to obey the law, so selling car insurance. House insurance. Yeah, got to have that. Health insurance. Yeah, we got to find a way to do that because most people need that and want that. Life insurance. Well, smart people understand that that's a good idea. Investments. Wait, want that retirement plan? Yeah, better do that. But disability income insurance. What would you do if you were disabled? Well, first of all, nobody wants to think about that. Secondly, nobody wants to believe it's going to happen to them. So how in the world do you get people to not only listen to your story, but perhaps buy disability income insurance? Well, Bob modestly told me that, you know, he didn't claim to be the smartest guy, and he wasn't the guy who knew everything. He was a kind of a simple farm-type boy who just was kind and friendly, and he certainly is all of that. He's just a nice guy. And he often told me that he often began, most often, a conversation when he was allowed to meet somebody on the basis of a recommendation or a referral of some kind. And he would usually begin by just introducing himself and saying, thank you, how can I help you? Now, get that. How can I help you? And then he said, and after they told me, I would try and help them. He doesn't have his pitch. He doesn't have his brochure. He doesn't have all of that stuff where, like the hot shot that I heard the other day, he is not pitching. He is being very present and listening and helping. And he said, you know what, no matter what it was, I tried to help them. And in doing so, and doing that often enough, and that is part of my style, I was able to be in situations very often where I was not only able to help them, but it certainly was a way that I could build a very successful and happy career. And basically, that's Bob's story. Now the hot shot that I heard on Sirius and on the cable channels, he was obviously a boy wonder. He was young and he was hot and he was selling a sales system. And this sales system, no matter what your product, no matter what your service, no matter what your industry, his system would work for you. And if you just buy him and his system, your troubles, your difficulties in selling and in the sales of your company are over. He could handle it. That's a lie. That's not true. He can't. And by the way, there is no sales system that works for everybody. And what I knew from listening to him was that he was simply doing and selling the same old sales system that many people in the insurance industry have been using for 70 years. Same old stuff. S-O-S. Same old stuff. Don't listen to them. As my good friend Frank said, I've been a salesman most of my life, and I was very good at it. But the way I sold is not the way you sell now. It's very different. Let me simply make this suggestion to you. We're going to help you, and one of the things we're going to do is we're going to have a nice little presentation. I think it will be a nice little presentation. With a smile, we're going to say, the secret Jesus knew. How Jesus sells. That's the name of the program. He knew. You got a great idea. You got the kingdom of God. And you got to bring people into it. How do you sell them on that? How do you do that? Well, we're going to learn from the master entrepreneur and from the man who knew how to help people change their lives, who found out what they wanted. And when the man said, I want to see, he said, okay, let's help you do just that. You're going to have to learn how to sell strong. And our system will say, first of all, you have to learn your strengths. What are you really good at? Then, what's your personal style? And then, no, you can't pitch them. You have to show them how good you are, how helpful you are, how you can help them. And whatever they need, just like Bob said, try and help them. Then you're going to have stories, and you're going to have to be able to demonstrate your wisdom and insight and be able to show people who you are and what you do, because you are a master storyteller. Jesus came into the world, told stories, asked questions. He didn't preach sermons and give many answers. Then, with that help, you will develop your own personal sales system that works for you. And nobody can design a system that works for you. Nobody can do it like you do it. And if you want to be good at selling, you'll certainly imitate the best and you'll learn from others. But eventually, through self-awareness, through developing your own spirit, your soul, and your strength, you'll be able to develop a system, personally for you, designed by you and friends and blessed by the Holy Spirit, hopefully, to help you be very good at doing what Jesus did, and that is to walk into the world and say, I've got some good news for you. And they listened. And those who responded were changed. There we go. Would you like to be one of those? Would you like to have some of those secrets? Would you like to have some of those things in your life? 10 minutes. 10 minutes of clarity. We're done. Please get in touch with me at radioedge77@gmail.com, radioedge77@gmail.com. And I'll simply say, when you call me, how can I help you? How can I help you? And you tell me. And then, if you'd like to know more about the way that we could help you, we can continue the conversation if you want. If this has been helpful to you, if you'd like to have the name of your program, your organization on the Master Entrepreneur, because we're going to be reaching people, hopefully all over the world, we'd be grateful if you'd step forward and perhaps support and sponsor us now. And if you'd like to be formally sponsoring us, we would be glad to help you, because together we can do good things together. As we oftentimes say on the Christian Entrepreneur Network, we want to do things so well that we make Jesus smile. All the best.